Hey everyone, welcome to this psychology lecture series. In this video, we are going to talk about Wilhelm Wundt. Wilhelm Wundt was born on 16th August 1832 in Germany and died on 31st August 1920, aged 88. Wilhelm Wundt is commonly referred to as the father of psychology. Before him, other people such as Hermann von Helmholtz, Gustav Fechner, and Ernst Weber were also involved in early scientific psychology research. But Wilhelm Wundt is credited as the father of psychology because he officially started psychology as a separate and distinct science. Wilhelm Wundt established the very first psychology laboratory in Leipzig, Germany in 1879. This is recognized as the formal establishment of psychology as a science distinct from biology and philosophy. Wilhelm Wundt was also the very first person to refer to himself as a psychologist. Wilhelm Wundt also formed the first academic journal for psychological research. It was published from 1881 to 1902. Wilhelm Wundt's background was in physiology, and this reflected in the topics such as the study of reaction times, sensory processes, and attention. For example, participants would be exposed to a standard stimulus such as a light or the sound of a metronome and asked to report their sensations. His aim was to record thoughts and sensations and to analyze them in the same way as a chemist analyzes chemical compounds. The school of psychology founded by Wilhelm Wundt is known as voluntarism. Voluntarism is the process of organizing the mind. Wilhelm Wundt is associated with the theoretical perspective known as structuralism. It involves describing the structures that compose the mind. Structuralism is regarded as the very first school of thought in psychology. Wilhelm Wundt relied on introspection to study mental processes. Though the method of introspection was inherited from philosophy, Wilhelm Wundt added a new dimension to this concept. Pure self-observation was not sufficient and it had to be supplemented by experiments. Though Wilhelm Wundt is associated with structuralism, it was actually his student Edward B. Titchener who influenced the structuralist school in America. Wilhelm Wundt's support of experimental psychology also set the stage for behaviorism, and many of his experimental methods are still used today. Wilhelm Wundt has trained during his academic career 186 graduate students, among which 116 students were trained in psychology. Some of his students who later became prominent psychologists are Edward Titchener, James McKean Kettle, Charles Spearman, Stanley Hall, Charles Jude, and Hugo Munsterberg. Wilhelm Wundt has wrote over 490 works and is one of the world's most prolific scientific writer. Some of his key works are Lectures on the Mind of Humans and Animals in 1863, Outline of Psychology in 1896, Principles of Physiological Psychology in 1873. In the next video, we will talk about Sigmund Freud. I hope you find this video useful. Please share these videos with everyone who is preparing for this exam. Thank you.